Welcome back to Southern Rails 1186. In today's video, we follow the Sequatchie Valley Switching Company with a bit of a twist. It's snowing. Sure, for some people this may seem like nothing, but for some who live in Southeast Tennessee, this is all we get. On January 15th, 2024, I started out on one of SQSC's newest lines, the Colonial Chemical Spur. This new spur originally started construction in early 2022 and was completed in mid-2023. SQSC was contracted by Colonial Chemical to serve the new spur, so SQSC SW1500-1205 was sent over to work the new spur in June of 2023. February 16, 2024, they received their first car from CSX. 1205 was originally built as Southern Pacific 2635 in May of 1972. In 1996, when Union Pacific acquired Southern Pacific, she became Y1205. The Y meaning yard, she was only used in yard service. In 2008, she was repainted in UP's armor yellow, losing her infamous SP blood nose scheme. In 2009, she was placed into storage along with some of her sisters. In 2012, she was put up for sale and purchased by the Sequatchie Valley Railroad. She operated with a patch for a little while until 2016, when she was painted into a similar UP scheme with a more vibrant yellow and gray, with BN decal placement. Whenever I got to CP Ellerton, the signal was illuminated approach limited, indicating a northbound was heading my way. Sure enough, a couple minutes later, the CSX hotbox detector, which was only a few miles away, had went off, and then the engineer called out over the radio that I-142 was coming around Nickajack Lake.
0.4, no defect. Repeat, no defect. Total axle 212, detector out.
After I-142 cleared Allerton, I decided to head to Bridgeport to see what I could find around there. To my surprise, I found SQSC GP15-1 number 717 in the yard, having some sand added to the rear of the hood. After adding sand, they left the yard bound for U.S. gypsum. Some crews were also in the yard cleaning up bits of cross ties, old spikes, and any other garbage around the yard.
Thank you.
After an hour and a half, the snow had stopped and it started raining. The Sequatchie crews finally finished switching sheetrock and were now headed to another section of gypsum to do more switching. Though I cut my outing short due to the fact that it was cold, raining, and everything overall being a mess, not having an umbrella didn't help my issue either. January 22nd, 2024, I found myself in Jasper, Tennessee watching SQSC-717 switching out Primex. According to Primex's website, they make anything from building materials, toys, medical applications, and more.
Yeah.
process.
Something I'd like to point out is that between January 15th and the 20th, parts of Tennessee had an ice storm. It started out as snow, but then it would turn to rain, and then the rain would freeze because it was so cold, so everything turned to ice. This occurrence stuck around for about a week. You can see some patches of snow or ice remaining in some parts of the video. The 717 was built in November of 1982 as Missouri Pacific GP15-1, number 1717, to replace their aging fleet of GP7s, 9s, and 18s. Earlier that same year, Union Pacific bought the Mopac, but the merger was not approved until 1997. So in 1997, 1717 became UPY, number 717. Similar to 1205, 717 was only used in yard and local freight service on UP's system. In 2015, she was put in storage until she was put up for auction in 2022 and then purchased by the Sequatchie Valley Switching Company.
Thank you. time we went to back here. I'm down to walk to back to my car. The car.
Thank you. Yeah, come on, one. No good. Pull back up a little bit there. Try it again there. Back there about 5 foot now. About 3, 2, 1 more good one. Third, give me a 3 step.
6 or about 6?
Clear, 6. I'm down there at the derail.
Flying log for the main upright.
Thank you.
got a switch line.
All right.
got your cross protection.
No traffic.
Y'all in the morning.
Copy that. Hey, tell Brandon we'll send it to him when we get to the office. We'll report.
Copy.